Hello friends, welcome back to Magic Knight Rayearth, episode 2. Happy Tuesday, this is 2 for Tuesday. So that first episode was a lot. There was a lot of exposition, a lot of info dumping that went on to set the stakes here. So the first thing I should do is start with a little recap. Well, the zeroth thing I should do is illustrated diary writing, which is how you save your game. But you can also read the diary of each of the three protagonists, or more accurately, listen to them read their diary, because there is complete voice acting for all of these entries. They serve as a little, you know, running recap of all of the events of the game. So, let's do that. I'll start with entry number 0 here, which is like the prologue.
My school went to the Tokyo Tower today on a field trip. The observation deck was so high, and everything below looked so tiny. Is it corny that I was excited about going there?
So, Umi and Fu don't have entry number 0. Theirs starts at number 1. But I'll go on ahead and read Hikaru's entry number 1 here.
Out of nowhere, a flash lit up the sky. And when I blinked, I was floating over a magical world called Sephiro, along with Umi and Fu, two girls I had just met. Then, a boy named Clef told us of our destiny as magic knights. I'm confused, but excited.
Hikaru isn't the only one who can keep a diary. I decided to keep one, too. That way, everything won't be filtered by her alone if someone ends up reading about this weird trip we're on.
Hikaru's leadership has inspired me to keep a journal of this adventure. I thought I would write down some basic observations about this world they call Sephiro, but it seems like I don't have enough room here to write enough to matter. Oh well, perhaps later.
Another strange thing happened. This evil woman named Alcyone attacked us, and when I went to attack her, I suddenly had command of this fiery magic blast. I was surprised, but I think Alcyone was blown away, literally. Anyway, I worry about Clef. But like Fu said, we have to keep moving forward, for Clef's sake.
Hikaru somehow called up a kind of fire magic and defeated an evil woman who was after us. It was very cool, and I'm kind of jealous. I wonder if I'll ever get something like that. If only Hikaru got magic, it wouldn't be fair.
Hikaru used a sort of flaming elemental blast to dispose of a woman who attacked Clef and then sought to destroy us. I wonder how the fire magic actually works. Oh well, this world is full of mysteries.
Alright, and that gets us up to speed. I really like the fonts. Each protagonist writes in their own handwriting, and they're very well-designed fonts. Like, it looks very natural. In the Japanese version, I don't think that was the case. I think this was something that Working Designs did for the game. Also, Working Designs is responsible for these being voiced. In the manual, there is a translator's note at the end that explains that in the Japanese version, all of the NPC dialogue was voiced. Just kind of all of the random interactions that you have with people. And they thought that that was annoying and frustrating, which I would probably agree. Have, you know, every unimportant bit of dialogue like that voice acted. And they said that they recorded these to sort of compensate for that. So instead of being forced to listen to a bunch of superfluous dialogue, you have the option of going in and listening to the characters reading their diary in their own words, which I think is a lot cooler. I think that was a good choice. Okay, but with that out of the way, now I can finally play the game. Hikaru, Umi, and Fu are here in the Forest of Silence. Hikaru has her fire arrow, Umi has nothing, and Fu has nothing. Yet. Hikaru cannot use the fire arrow because the Forest of Silence is magic proof, but that will be changing soon. You can swap between the three protagonists at any time by pressing the left and right shoulder buttons, and the swap is instantaneous. The characters that you're not controlling, they don't do anything that benefits you in any way, but you also don't have to worry about like protecting them, babysitting them, keeping them from taking damage or anything. For all intents and purposes, the active character is the only character, and the other two are just kind of, you know, they're there for moral support. And sometimes when they get separated from you, there can be some like weird animations, like they float across the screen. You know, it's not super realistic, quote unquote, but I don't play Magic Knight Rayearth on the Sega Saturn for realism. Alright, so to the east. Clef told us to... Oh. Here we are.
Hello? Anybody home?
It seems as if no one is at home right now.
Perhaps this isn't even Precia's house.
Did you see that? The door just opened.
What kind of person leaves their home unlocked? It's not safe.
Well, let's not waste time just talking about it.
You mean, go into the house? Isn't that bad manners?
Okay, fine. You stay out here with your manners and the monsters, and we'll go in.
I haven't seen any monsters. I thought there was another way that I could go. I guess not yet. So, Clef told us to head east from the Forest of Silence to find Precia's manor, and here we are. That was quite the journey. There were many trials and tribulations along the way. Foo's dancing. But we finally made it. That's a nice fountain. Can't interact with that. This looks like a place that I should be able to rest, but it's just some stuff to look at. So, when you inspect things, there's actually different thoughts for each of the three characters. And it's usually just rephrasing the same thing, but sometimes you get little unique perspectives, and the protagonists will react differently to things sometimes. So, for completeness sake, to document this game as thoroughly as possible, I'll be going through all three of the observations for everything I can inspect. I agree, Foo. In fact, let's just live here. Forget about the rest of the game. I think we could live out our days here in peace and tranquility. Cow tools. Just a plain old vase. Impeccable taste. See, Foo agrees with me. Let's just live here. Gross. So I have to wonder how much of this was in the original text and how much of it is just improvisation. I mean, when a game has this much text to translate, I can see why one would want to add their own little personal flair to it. What's that? Brescia? Is that you? We've been sent here by Clef. Brescia? Oh, great. Not this again. Ha. You're the clumsiest band of thieves I've ever seen. Yeah, that's what I meant. Now that I've caught you, the expense of this cage seems suddenly worthwhile. Why do you call us thieves? Didn't you hear? Clef sent us. Lies. Simply the desperate lies of a bumbling criminal. You can't fool me, thief. The only problem is that now I shall have a terrible time choosing how to punish you. Punish us? Yes, punishment. Why? Is that unexpected, thief? Weren't you listening? We're not thieves. Clef sent us to save your stinking world. Ha 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 ha. Poo poo. Now that I get a good look at you, you're not that scary after all. I know this must all be a terrible misunderstanding. I mean, we did come in without permission, and you have a right to be angry. But we're not thieves. In fact, now that I think of it, the door opened by itself. We just walked inside. Not a legal defense, unfortunately. What did you say? We're not thieves? No, after that. No need to yell. I said that the door opened by itself. And yes, it was quite rude of us to come in uninvited, but we did call for you repeatedly. That door was held with a lock enchanted by High Priest Clef. It cannot be opened. But if it opened for you, then you must be magic knights. Gasp. That's weird. I feel like it just skipped a dialogue box. No, my name is Hikaru. I'm Umi. And I'm Fu. We were sent here by Clef to find Brescia. Then it finally begins. The legendary battle comes swiftly.
Magic Knights, it is my duty to welcome you here. Oh, and by the way, my name is Brescia. I'm the senior commander here on Sephiroth.
I agree, Rat Monster. Makona is so happy that you have finally come. Makona? This is the Makona we're looking for? Please don't be offended. We only received very limited instructions from Clef. He told us to seek out Brescia to get the weapons and join Makona. That was all. Well, it seems you have succeeded. Now then, follow me. Alright, stuff to examine. Good question, Umi. Oh, now that... I don't know, that might have been in the original. One of those classic green shaded lamps. Famously used by, like, bankers and accountants. I mean, that's pretty traditional for... Well, never mind. Fu, always with the witty observations. Umi, always the cranky one. Good old Fu. Instead of just standing around wondering about the book, she actually tries to read it. Follow that lady and that rat monster. I guess it's more of a rabbit monster. Wow. Prisha, did you really make all of these weapons? Yes, I crafted each of them myself, and now the time has come for you to choose one. It's incredibly generous of you to give us these marvelous weapons for free. Free? Wherever did you get that idea? What? We don't have any money. Perhaps Clef assumed we would expect to pay for such fine weapons as these. Relax, payment is not what I want from you. But you just said that you may take any weapon you desire, but ownership remains with me. Alone, if you wish. All the weapons I craft are made for my use alone. Likewise, your weapons will be made solely for your use. But didn't you just say that we should pick from these weapons? To reach Eterna, you must have some weapons. Until yours are ready, you may use mine. Eterna? Never fear, I shall make you the best weapon Sephiroth has ever witnessed. All you must do is fight your way to Eterna and gather the materials needed to make them. Fight? Suddenly, it's clear. They do not cost money because we supply the raw materials. That's right, Fu. I'm glad you understand. Now go to Eterna and bring back lots of Escudo. Escudo? She's like Solid Snake here. In the world of Sephiroth, Escudo is the only material suitable for aura weapon. Weapons crafted from Escudo will increase in power and ability with their owner. Fantastic. That means you don't have to find stronger weapons, doesn't it? Yes, but the reverse is also true. If the owner does not grow, neither will the weapon. You mean our physical strength, correct? I don't think I have another growth spurt left. Correct. And Escudo weapons are required to revive the machines. Machines. Clef also spoke of this. What exactly are the machines? I do not know details of their inner workings, but they are immense and hold great power. But that is getting ahead of the task at hand. First, bring me the Escudo. To reach Eterna, you must pass through the Forest of Silence, where magic has no effect. Weapons will be your only defense, so choose from amongst these wisely. So you're saying that the forest is populated with slimy, gross monsters? Maybe a few. Few? How few? I'm not certain exactly. Many warriors have left for Eterna, but none have returned. What? And that is precisely why I have urged you to take a weapon. Now that you know the danger, I know you will choose it very carefully. Call out with your heart and a magical weapon will be drawn to you. Color-coded for convenience sake. I'm a member of the archery club at school, and I practice kendo, the art of fighting with swords made of bamboo. Likewise, I am chief of the fencing club. It seems that the right weapons chose us in some magical way. How weird. Not weird. Destiny. Well then, our destiny awaits. How do we get to Eterna again? Okona will travel with you and keep you from straying. I don't know, rabbits don't have tails like that. The tail definitely looks more rat-like to me. Which isn't a problem, rats are cute, but it's just a matter of classification. Oh, here we go. Get ready.
And Precious.
Mysterious Sephiroth Lecture number 1.
You have accomplished the first objective of your journey. Makona is in your party.
It is foretold that Makona will be no end of help to the Magic Knights.
You should already know to press Start in order to access the command menu.
And there you can use items that Makona is holding for you and change various settings.
The most important command to remember is Illustrated Diary Writing.
Use it often, and you will have many wonderful memories of your adventures. You now know the basics. Time to end the session and return to the game. Have fun!
See you later, kids!
Alright, who's ready to have fun? Thank you, Prisha. No thanks are necessary. Just bring back the Escudo as soon as you can. It sounds like a daunting task, but we'll do our best on this adventure. I just hope we're alive to tell our story when it's done. What kind of parting comment is that? You want to jinx the whole thing? I guess this means we're off. More cutscenes? Do I get to play? Alright. First thing I want to do is go back exactly where I just came from. See if there's anything else to explore, any more information I can glean from Prisha. Travel to the Fountain of Eterna immediately and retrieve the escudo. When you return with it, I will create incredible weapons for you. So even though we have our weapons now, I can't use them until I get to an actual combat scene. There's no weapon use allowed in town settings. Alright. Look around. Very important observations going on here. I hope you're all taking notes. That's a good point, Umi. Yeah, it does look a bit stage-like. Or a bit door-like. Either interpretation, I think, is valid. Fu's not afraid of the cannon. Fu's my favorite, in case you weren't able to tell. She's just very... She has a good head on her shoulders, you know? Alright, I believe that is all there is to look at in Prisha's manner. This is odd. The road looks a bit different than it was before. Well, it's a mysterious forest after all. Which way should we go now? Well, whatever way we can go. Let's go. So yeah, this path to the right doesn't open until you do all of the interactions with Prisha, but still can't go this way. We just get a hint of things to come. This game has very good music, by the way. Alright, finally some action. So, Hikaru has... I suppose that would count as a short sword. Umi has... a rapier. Oh, I really like this forest music. This is... some nice, mysterious, you know, it's adventure music, but it's foreboding a little bit. Just the right amount. And then Fu has the bow and arrow. I usually stick with Fu because she has the bow and arrow. You know, it's a little like a Zelda game. And in The Legend of Zelda, if you were always able to throw your sword, obviously you would. So that little blue thing would restore some magic points if I had used any. Still can't use magic yet, even with Hikaru. The magic button does nothing because this is the Forest of Silence. The monsters will drop little health restoration pellets, they'll drop magic, and they will drop little gems. And I forget what the currency is called. That might be like a form of escudo as well. So I now have one escudo, if indeed that is what that is. I don't know how much or if Working Designs tweak the difficulty of this game. In the translator's note, they say something about improving the enemy AI, which I'm not sure what that actually means. But these worm things only take one hit to defeat, which feels about right. And then those crab monsters take like 5 hits, which feels like a little much. I feel like Working Designs might have boosted some of the monster health arbitrarily, because that's the kind of thing that they do. Ooh, the forest is changing all around me. Before my very eyes. Well, not before my eyes, but just off screen. Yeah, Working Designs significantly... That was a scary looking monster. They significantly boosted the difficulty of Popful Mail. And I think there was a little bit of that going on in this game, but maybe not to the same extent. Well, my arrows do nothing. Let's try talking to it. Oh, I can't bear to watch this pathetic display of swordsmanship any longer. I'm using a bow and arrow. Huh? Who is it? Who's there? Look, over there.
What do you know? Just girls.
Hey, I resemble that remark. It's Slick Jr. the Third. Or a reasonable facsimile. When you surprise someone, isn't it good manners to state your name first, rude boy? Well, I never thought of that. Sorry? Anyway, I, the Magnificent Furio, saved your life. Why are you so ungrateful? Actually, it might be Furio. I don't mean to seem ungrateful. I apologize. My name is Fu. My name is Umi. And I am Hikaru. This is the Forest of Silence. Magic cannot be used here. What's worse, the place is crawling with monsters. If your sword skills are not up to snuff, coming here is an easy way to get your sweet selves killed. Are you implying that we're sissies? I don't know what a sissy is, but I am saying you need help. Big, beefy, hunter hunk type help, like myself. Say, how about you hire me as your bodyguard and guide? You'll be out of here in a flash. What do you think? You've seen my skill with a sword, and I know this forest like the back of my hand. Do you work cheap? Well, actually, I mean to say, do you work free? You see, we, don't have any money. All I ask in exchange for my services is food. I haven't eaten well for weeks. Food? Is that it? We can do that. Makona will supply you with all you can ask for. Wait a minute, Hikaru. How can you be so careless with a stranger? For all we know, Furio could have ties to Zagat. Have you even considered that? If that were the case, why would he have saved us from that monster? It could be a trap to try to get us to trust him. I saw that in a movie once. But if we let him travel along with us, we've got a chance of getting out of here alive. We have decided we won't be needing a bodyguard. So if you don't mind, we'll be on our way now. Besides, we generally don't trust hunters hiding near monster nests. Did I say that? So you're saying you lied to us? Listen, sister, I'm more of a swordsman, but a hunter is not a stretch. Never mind. Have you heard of a man called Zagat? He's said to have captured Princess Emerald. I've been pursuing him up until recently, when I was nearly captured. I found my way into this forest, and now I can't seem to find my way out. Now do you see, Fu? Maybe we should ask for his help after all. Yeah, but he's such a loser. I mean, he's lost, for heaven's sake. He did say he knew this forest, and now he admits he's lost too. First you tell us a blatant lie, and now you expect us to take you at your word? Sheesh, you three are way too suspicious. Fine, have it your way. Don't hire me. If you insist. But that doesn't mean I can't trail you lovely ladies on my own. Ugh. Huh? Oh, why not? Whatever. I'm getting a headache. Okay, well, I don't exactly know what that was all about. What the disagreement was. I don't know. Anyway, that'll do it for today's installment of Magic Knight Rayearth. Tune in tomorrow and see if we ever find our way out of the Forest of Silence. See ya.